Pleasure. Be careful.
I want you to say hi to Ushi.
Hi to Ushi. Schatz, vermisse dich schon. Ruf doch mal an.
Say hi, Ursula.
Hello, Ursula. We're here to listen to Lenz.
Oh, yeah.
And other ones. Before we start the show, we would like to ask that you please take a moment and silence your cell phones. We also remind you that there's no flash photography during the performance. And now please give a warm welcome to Mr. Jens Lindemann.
Also considered such beasts. That is Ryan DeWeese. He's going to do his best to try to bring me down tonight. It's not going to happen. This is like National Geographic and there's meat on the floor and he's the hyena, I'm the lion. That's as good as the jokes get tonight, all right, so just deal with that. That first tune was called Thank You. And Caesar's like, yes, stop talking, play the trumpet. Yes, I will do just that. We open with a great tune called Well Get It. Well Get It was the very first tune. Which one of you two, Ryan or Jimmy, knows the opening to Tommy Dorsey's famous opening ballad? Sitting in the audience listening to that tune, and he was 14, he heard that, and then the curtains opened up and they played Well Get It, and Doc Severinsen knew that he was going to be a musician from that moment on. He is now one of my closest friends. He's 96 years young. Woo! And when I was 12 years old, I first heard Doc in concert. And I was sitting there in Edmonton, my hometown in Canada, and he walked out on stage wearing pink leather pants and a lime green jacket. And he walked to the front of the stage and he said, "Ladies and gentlemen, I don't wear these pants because I look good in them. I wear them because I like the way they feel." And I knew right away I was going to be a musician at that point. There is such a joy, a love that comes when you are musicians and artists wanting to share with audiences. And we're here to share this with you tonight, the beauty of the power of music. So, it's your time to have audience participation moment. You don't know that, but it's about to happen. It's dark, don't worry, but you will be singing. This is a tune called Orange Colored Sky, made famous by Nat King Cole. You know it? Have you heard it? Ah, it's beautiful. Little underscoring always helps a monologue that's flailing. In the middle of this song, you will yell, "Flash, bam, alakazam." I don't trust you based on the first amount of applause that I can draw out of you, so we're going to practice that right now.
Flash, bam, alakazam.
You're going to have... we got a singer in the audience. All right, I got a microphone here. You're going to sing that on cue when we play this. This is Nat King Cole's version as arranged by our genius in-house artistic director, Orange Color Sky by Matt Cattenbrew.
Transcription.
transcriptions you can possibly imagine. The string quartet of Shostakovich 8 was written for four string players. They are attempting with six trumpets only. They represented UCLA at the National Trumpet Competition just a few weeks ago, ended up in the top four of 45 ensembles all around North America. And in 10 days, they will be competing in Minneapolis, Minnesota at the International Trumpet Guild Conference. So I said, what a great place to do your dress rehearsal. Catalina Jazz Club. And I'm so proud not only of their music making, but of these young people. Our job as people who are elder statesmen and leaders in the field are to pay it forward. And I can't think of a better representation for the young generation of tomorrow. From left to right, we will be representing Mr. Eric Klein on trumpet, Morgan Bates on trumpet, Remy O'Hara on trumpet. Actually, they're all on trumpet. I don't know why I said that. Cyrus Alva on trumpet, Emma Green on flugelhorn, and Spitty Smith on low flugelhorn. Ladies and gentlemen, the UCLA Trumpet Ensemble. You know, I got a saxophone that's been lying under the bed of my house for about 25 years, belonged to my dad. Rob said, hey, why don't we pull it out? Pulled it out, showed it to Jan, whose jaw hit the floor. Apparently, this is one of the most classic Selmer saxophones ever built. And Poker Man, who obviously lost a big, big hand to Rob, ended up actually, in all seriousness, donating it to UCLA for future students to use. That is a very, very significant moment in time. So I want to thank you, Rob, for your gambling problem. UCLA was the beneficiary of that. To that end, I actually wanted Jan to play a couple of notes from Jan's specialty, which is classical music, so you can hear this classic instrument from the 1950s. And now in the hands of a master, and soon to be in the hands of master students. So thank you for that. I want to thank Betty for being here. Betty and Arlene, I met them at a Mexican restaurant about a month ago. They're both a little hard of hearing. You can hear they're yelling at each other. And I said, Betty, come to the concert at Catalina's. And she said, yes, I'll come. This morning, I got a text message. Are we still invited to Catalina's? I said, of course. Right in the front row, and formerly a USO girl, there she is, Betty, right in the front. So many cool people people here tonight. Aubrey and Joyce Chernikov haven't seen in years. The pandemic drew us apart. Catalina's has brought us back together. Thank you for being here. Also in the front row, I have Kim Walker, who's a great friend. Her husband was the Consul General to Canada, and she and he lived here for Los Angeles. The appointment ended, and you know what? They stayed in LA because they loved it so much. Thank you for coming to Los Angeles. And then right behind her, there's a table of six of my neighbors. I call them the German Mafia. They're sort of not all Germans, but they're all Germanic speaking. And they're here tonight, and they come to just about everything I ever do. So I want to thank Klaus and all of his friends, not only for their passion for music, but supporting all things live. Thank you for coming tonight. But I save some applause for a man sitting beside Kim. He's got a lot of hair on his head. When I was a young boy, growing up in Edmonton, there was a great pop tune on the radio. It was all across Canada. It was a smash hit. It won this man a Juno Award. It's the Canadian equivalent of a Grammy. He was a rock star. I was 14 years old at summer band camp, and I was dancing with Sherry Pokarny when this song came on. Yeah, you know Sherry. There was Tim Feehan singing, 'Cause I'm leaving for Maui tomorrow. I hope I will see you again. And I was right there, man. It was even higher.
Higher than Barry Gibb.
Higher than Barry Gibb. So, ladies and gentlemen, a hero, a Canadian hero, a Juno Award winner, big producer here in town, Mr. Tim Feehan, sitting in the front row. Thank you. In 1924, which means we're in 23, next year is the centenary of Gershwin's epic Rhapsody in Blue. And it became, for those lawyers in the room, public domain about 5 years ago. It's an important term that I did not learn at Juilliard. It meant that we could do the arrangement. And Matt did a brilliant job of an 11-piece big band arrangement of Rhapsody in Blue for the original classical morning from Vancouver, Canada. Ladies and gentlemen, please let me welcome to Catalina in his debut, Mr. Ian Parker. That's correct. Thank you. I'm going to move a couple of things here because Maestro needs the space to work in. What I'm also going to tell you about this piece is that Ian and I did a recording, which we're about to release, and you're going to hear it, and you're going to see it on video. It was actually, we recorded it in Calgary, Alberta, at the National Music Center, where they had built, Steinway built only 24 of these particular instruments. They were called the Gershwin, or pardon me, they were called the Rhapsody in Blue Piano. And the Rhapsody, the National Music Center in Canada has one of those instruments. Ian played on that piano, that's on the video, that's on the recording itself. It's one of the first solo pieces he ever played. And I'm going to let the music do the talking. Ladies and gentlemen, this is not only Ian Parker, this is a piece of American and international musical history. We're about to celebrate its centenary. This is Rhapsody in Blue.